Today what we're going to be doing is loosening a frozen caliper bleed screw. This one is very much corroded. This is a 2003 Subaru Forester. It is currently 2019 and it's been a New England car for its whole life. This has seen quite a bit of salt and road grime, and as a result this is quite rusted. What we're going to effectively do is thermally shock this bleed screw, and that's going to break it loose and allow us to take it out. So first thing I'm doing is removing the boot that covers it, and second I'm going to take this aluminum foil and cover anything nearby that we want to protect from the heat, because we are thermally shocking this. Anything rubber is going to be the biggest issue. So the boots here on the caliper slide pins, we got the rubber line obviously that's coming in, and then we've got the sway bar end links here. Anything like that, you just want to try to shield as best as we can. That way we're not cooking the crap out of all those and creating new issues for ourselves. Now that everything is reasonably masked, we're going to take this wire brush and clean off all the debris here around the base of the screw where it meets the actual caliper. If you want, if you don't have enough room, you can do it before doing the aluminum foil. I like to mask it that way if I overshoot something, I don't hit it with the brush either, because this can potentially poke holes. So you don't have to spend hours scrubbing this. I mean, you can just see some of the dust coming off of it. That's what you're looking to do, is get the bulk of it off. And the reason why is because after we do this, we are going to be spraying some penetrating oil down into that base, and having all this debris out of the way is gonna make it soak in a lot faster and a lot more effectively. Now that we're happy with how cleaned off it is, we're gonna take a little bit of PB Blaster in this case, but you can use whatever your favorite is. And again, you're just gonna be spraying it there around the base, and try not to get it on your brakes. This is penetrating oil, so if you get it on your brakes, it will probably impede your braking ability. Now I'm gonna be putting on some gloves, because our next step is going to be using a torch. In this case, I've got a propane torch. You can also use map gas or butane or whatever your preference is. It doesn't really matter as long as it gets hot. It's just how hot the torch is will be affecting how long you're going to be keeping heat on it for. You're also going to want to have a bottle of water nearby. Colder is better, but I mean, this is just tap cold and it's going to be good enough. And have the cap off so that you are ready to pour that out. Now I light the torch and we're just going to heat at the base. If you do overspray like I did, you are going to get some of that penetrating oil to light up. Just blow it out as it happens. You can also just wait for it to go out on its own, but that's a little sketchy, so I'm not going to be doing that. What you're really looking to get is not necessarily the bolt itself, but also the caliper that surrounds it below. You're trying to get the caliper to expand more than the screw does, but also the thermal shocking by pouring water over it is going to make it break a lot quicker. If you do heat one more than the other, it's not a huge deal. What happens is the heat transfers between them anyway, and both of them are going to be very hot if you touch them, so do not touch those. They will stay hot for a good period of time afterwards. Now we got that heated, we're going to put this down a little bit and just pour water on it. You can see it was bubbling out really quick. Gotta take our 8mm wrench. And it just turned. So that's all you really need to do. It's as simple as that. If it doesn't release on the first time, other tricks you can do are tap it with a hammer. And then if needed, you can also reheat it, re-soak it with penetrating oil, and then re-quench it as needed.
Quick side note here, if it doesn't work on the first or second try, the thermal shock method will still work. It'll just take somewhere between 10 and 15 tries. So like I said, it helps to tap it with a hammer every couple cycles that you do this. But if it doesn't work the first or second time, don't get discouraged. I've never had this not work after about 10 to 15 times.
Yep, no issues at all. Opens up super easy now. So that is all it takes to free up a stuck bleeder screw on a caliper. Thank you guys for watching.